You might be wondering why this might be useful. Never fear. We'll have two good examples in this unit and cover the first one here and the second a little later. So let's consider the problem of sparse matrix dense vector multiplication, which we abbreviate SpMv, sparse matrix vector. Many interesting matrices have lots of zeros, so we call those matrices sparse, and we want to find a data structure to represent them that squeezes out the zeros, as well as to find a more efficient way to multiply them by vectors. After all, if there's lots of zeros, we'll do lots of multiplications that have no effect. So sparse matrices are incredibly common in computational problems in many domains. For instance, PageRank is the world's largest matrix computation. PageRank is based on a giant sparse matrix that represents every web page in the world. How big is this matrix? Well, if there's n web pages in the world, this matrix is n by n. And each entry at row r and column c is non-zero only if web page r links to web page c. So the PageRank computation on this sparse matrix is how Google computes the importance of web pages. Let's briefly refresh how we multiply a matrix by a vector. Students who already know this are welcome to skip to the next segment. So we're going to multiply this 3x3 matrix here by this 3x1 matrix here. So how do we do this? For each output in the output vector, we multiply the row of the input matrix by the column of the input vector. So we do this in a pairwise way, a times x plus b times y plus c times z. And that will create the entry here, ax plus by plus cz. For each additional row in the output matrix, we simply do another one of these dot products. So for instance, to compute this value here, we dot product this vector with, again, our input vector to get g times x plus h times y plus I times z. So let's do a matrix times a vector as a quiz. We're going to have this sample 3x3 matrix times this sample 3x3 vector, and I'd like you to write the vector answer in these three blanks here.